I'd like to remind you there's no smoking inside Williams Auditorium. Please take a moment before the show to take note of the fire exits on the left and right side on the lower portion of the auditorium and at the upper end where you entered the building. To better enjoy the show tonight, and as a courtesy to the audience members around you and the cast, we ask you please turn off all cell phones and remain in your seats during the scenes of tonight's show. There will be a 15-minute intermission between Act Number 1 and Act Number 2. The Hee Haw cast and crew would like to dedicate this year's performance in memory of Miss Wanda Smith. Miss Wanda was a part of the original Chester County Hee Haw cast back in 1981 and a true servant for Chester County. Live from Williams Auditorium, the Henderson Chester County Chamber of Commerce and the People's Bank present the 2016 Henderson Hee Haw Hootenanny. And now your hosts, Buck Owens and Roy Clark.
One, two, three, four, hee. Hee hee. Hee hee. And a whole Hee Haw game.
Featuring Buck Owens, Roy Clark, Gordy Tapp, Archie Campbell, Lulu Roman, Goober, Cousin Minnie Pearl, String Bean, Grandpa Jones, Tim Young, and the Good Time Band, and the whole Hee Haw Gang.
One, two, three, four. Hee-haw. 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 Well, hello there, and here we go.
Just in time for a brand new show.
Jokes and songs for everyone.
Come on, gang, let's have some fun.
Nurse Goodbody, could you take my calls today? I really don't want to be bothered. I got some important business to tend to.
Hello, doctor's office. Oh, yes, ma'am. This is Nurse Goodbody. Oh, yes, ma'am. The doctor is in today.
Nurse Goodbody. No, not today. I'm working.
Oh, you know what? I'm sorry. He's not in today. What's wrong? He's having some hemorrhoid troubles. Yes, ma'am.
Nurse Goodbody. Hemorrhoids? I've got a reputation. Hemorrhoids.
You know, not hemorrhoids. No. He's had the stomach bug all morning. Yes, ma'am. He's been throwing up, having bad diarrhea. Yuck. Oh, he's just disgusting. I know. What? Yes, ma'am. He will be here tomorrow. Uh-huh.
Nurse Goodbody. Not tomorrow. Got an important game.
Oh, you know what? I forgot. He's not going to be here tomorrow. He's going to be playing golf all day. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. You can talk to him later night at home. He'll be there then. Uh-huh. No,
Nurse Goodbody, not tonight. Hot date tonight.
Oh, you know what? I forgot. He's got a hot date tonight. Yes, ma'am. I'll be sure to give him your message. Okay, then. Thank you.
Well, Nurse Goodbody, want to tell me who you're talking to?
Oh, it was just your wife.
Call!
Hey, Goom.
Yeah?
You hear about my old buddy Roy McIntyre nearly drowning?
No, what happened?
Yeah, he was trying to dig a grave for a fella that wanted to be buried at sea.
Oh, Lord.
Well, honey, I've been looking over your records, and I've decided you have acute bronchitis.
Oh, thank you, doctor.
Este doctorcito es tan maravilloso, está precioso.
You know, my boy wants to become a doctor. He wants to study obstetrics.
Well, that's just a waste of time. You know, by the time he gets done learning all there is to know about obstetrics, somebody is going to come along with a cure for it.
Hey, Doc.
Yeah?
Is there a cure for dandruff?
Buck, there he is. There's a surefire cure for dandruff. It's called baldness.
You know, I just absolutely refuse to sit on a bus and watch a woman stand up.
Of course. What do? Give her your seat?
No, close my eyes.
Since my wife left me, I can't sleep a wink at night.
Aw, you really miss her that much?
Heck no, she took her only bed with her. You know, the only thing about Christmas I don't like is that my kids get up way too early.
Well, not mine, because I tell them Santa's fat because he eats kids that get up early.
This year, I ain't a-giving no Christmas gifts. Nope. I've decided I'm giving everybody my opinion.
Come on. Junior, I hear you went to New York City.
Yeah, I did. Went up out walking through that Central Park.
Yeah.
This fella come up, he put a gun up to my head.
Uh-oh.
He said, give me your money or I'll blow your brains out.
Well, what did you do?
I told him just go ahead and blow my brains out. Then Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump done proved you can get along without no brains. But you sure can't get by without no money.
Oh, well, somebody please help me. I'm just a prisoner in a country cornfield.
Hee-haw salutes the friendship community. Population 1,761.
Salute!
Hee-haw salutes the Dingberg community. Population 670.
Salute!
Please put your hands together for Flea Temptation performing Turn Your Radio On.
Clap if you remember the original Hee Haw Quartet singing Turn Your Radio On. Clap if you liked it. All right. This is nothing like this. Hope you like it.
Come and listen in to a radio station where the mighty host of heaven sings.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on. If you want to hear the songs of Zion coming from a land of endless spring,
get in touch with God.
Get in touch with God. Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
And listen to the music in the air.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on. Heaven's glory share,
heaven's glory share.
Turn your lights down low,
turn your lights down low.
And listen to the master's radio.
Get in touch with God,
get in touch with God. Turn your radio on,
turn your radio on.
Listen to the songs of the fathers and the mothers and the many friends gone on before.
Turn your radio on,
turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on,
turn your radio on. Some eternal morning we shall meet them over on the hallelujah shore.
Get in touch with God.
Get in touch with God. Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
And listen to the music in the air.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on. Heaven's glory share.
Heaven's glory share.
Turn the lights down low.
Turn the lights down low.
And listen to the master's radio.
Get in touch with God.
Get in touch with God. Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Listen to the music in the air.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Heaven's glory share.
Heaven's glory share.
Turn the lights down low.
Turn the lights down low. listen to the Masters Radio. Get in touch with God.
Get in touch with God.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Hey.
I've been a-thinking.
Oh, boy.
Why don't you go get yourself one of them there jobs and go to work? Because you know that worrying kills more folks than work does.
I know, Teresa, but the problem is nothing worries me more than having to go to work.
Anybody would care to tell their age.
Well,
I don't mind admitting that I'm approaching 30.
Oh, yeah? From what direction, honey?
On the sands of time, their footprints are intact.
But the places we've been and the trouble we've been in,
we spend all our time just covering our tracks.
Gloom, despair, and agony on me. Deep, dark depression, excessive misery. Oh.
A duck and Santa.
I don't know what.
A Christmas quacker.
Hey, Ella.
What?
What's the difference between a knight and Santa's reindeer?
Well, I don't know what.
One slays the dragon and the other one's dragging the sleigh.
Hey, Luke. What do you get when you cross a snowman with a vampire?
I don't know. What?
Frostbite.
I'm a picket.
And I'm a grinning.
People around town are talking about how lazy you are. And they say that you don't like work.
That ain't so. I don't mind work as long as I don't have to do it. Hey, Buck.
Yep.
I forgot what I'm supposed to say. Oh, I know.
Okay, yeah, you got it.
Yeah. Hey, Buck, you remember when women used to wear long dresses and hats?
Why, no. But why would I want to?
Yeah.
here you got your wife a beautiful diamond ring for Christmas.
I got one.
That's right. Sure did.
But I thought you said you're going to get her one of those sporty four-wheel drive vehicles.
Well, she did. But have you ever seen a fake Jeep? Buck, do you have many childhood, not again.
Not yet. No. You hear about old, did you hear about old Junior getting arrested?
Why was Junior arrested?
Because he was doing his Christmas shopping early.
Well, what's wrong with doing your Christmas shopping early?
Well, it's wrong if it's before the store opens.
Oh!
Yeah.
I got it now. Did you ever have any early memories of Christmas?
Well, not many, Roy. You know, we were pretty poor growing up, so I don't have a lot of memories.
Oh, well, how poor were you?
Well, we were so poor that instead of changing gifts, we just had to exchange glances.
You?
Well, you know, give you a few examples. Christmas, I got a set of batteries with a note on it with it that said, toys not included. I said a few examples. We used to have to eat our cereal with a fork. Yeah. That way we could pass the milk down to the next kid.
Oh.
One more.
All right, one more.
Oh, I promise, just one more.
Good, okay.
We only changed underwear once a week.
Oh, no.
Yep, I changed with Charlie, and Tommy changed with Billy.
The Jacks Creek community, population 1,125.
Silence! Excuse me. Hey, Hall salutes the Fanger community, population 734.
Silence!
Performing Christmas in Dixie, please welcome to the stage Mr. John McBride.
Sunshine's falling down, and maybe down in Memphis, Graceland's all in lights, and in Atlanta, Georgia, there's peace on earth tonight. Christmas Dixie. It's snowing in the pine. Merry Christmas from Dixie to everyone tonight.
Good friend Will Young on the guitar.
Chicago. The kids are out of school. There's magic in Motown. The city's on the move. In Jackson, Mississippi, to Charlotte, and all across the nation, it's a peaceful Christmas time. Christmas in Dixie, it's snowing in the pine. Merry Christmas from Dixie to everyone tonight. And from the Chester County Chamber, Merry Christmas tonight.
Y'all have a safe holiday season. Thank y'all.
Roy?
Hey.
How you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing all right. How about you?
Oh, not too bad. I'm assuming you just want a little off the top.
Yeah.
Yeah. Somebody beat me to it, Roy.
Yeah. It's not too hot.
No, it's not. Well, hey, I saw you eating some of those cookies back there.
Yeah.
You like them?
Pretty good.
Boy, that reminds me of a story.
Oh, no.
Yeah, boy. I bet you like story here, story too, wouldn't you, Roy?
Not really.
Not
but
really.
I guess
well,
we're
going
to have to.
Yeah, you're probably going to have to. Well, Roy, I think I'll tell you. Have you heard the one about Riddle Ed hiding Rood?
No.
Boys, well, we'll just start with that one. How's that, Roy?
All right.
Well, a long time ago, way back in the forest, lived this Gittle Earl, and her name was Riddle Ed hiding Rood.
Yeah.
Now, one day, Riddle Ed's mother came up to her. She said, Riddle Ed, I got some mad booze to tell you.
Booze?
Riddle Ed just said, what? She said, yes, I hate to tell you, but your sandmother's very geek. Well, Riddle Ed, it just hoke or bark. She cat down and shried.
Oh.
Her mother said, Riddle Ed, don't get there and shry. I tell you what. I'll make you a hash fried catch of bookies to take to your gig sand mother. Now, Roy, I'm not talking about those that you can buy from the Skirl Gals. You know, they're always set up at the Mallwart Larkin Pot. I'm talking about hash fromade catch of bookies. You've seen the size of Riddle Ed's mother's bookies, haven't you?
No, I haven't. Sure haven't.
Well, I guarantee you String has.
How big are they, String? How big are they?
His wife kicked him out for a month after she caught him with those bookies. But String said they were so good they make you want to map your slimer. Well, but you know who else lives way back in the forest?
Yeah.
That big wad wolf.
Oh.
Yes, sir. You know, normally, though, he don't bother anybody. He's usually funting for hood. You know what he eats all day, though, don't you?
Bookies.
No. He don't eat bookies. He sheets eats.
Does what?
He sheets eats. And this particular day, he had sheets so many eats.
He had an Ellie Bake and a Boar Sodom.
Oh, whew. That's bad.
So he does decide, hey, I'd like to get in on some of those bookies. So he sneaks over to Riddle Ed's Gick Sandmother's house.
Yeah.
He reads in the pendo, sees Gick Sandmother buying in lead.
Buying in
her lead.
Buying in her lead.
So he beats up to the crib and he jumps up and he eats up the Gick Sandmother.
Oh, no.
Hobbles her up gold. But then, you know, he got a little sneaky and he put on her bonnet and her gait now and he bumped into Jed.
Bumped? Who's Jed?
The one that he bumped into.
Oh, okay. All right.
But you know, Roy, fellas, Bo Naughty wants to hum comb and find a winky old snuff buying in your Gick Sandmother's lead. Well, what? Not much longer, here comes Riddle Ed.
Yeah?
So she comes and she docks on the Nore. Bo Naughty answers. She docks on the Nore again. Finally, the big bad wolf says, come on in.
Yeah?
So Riddle Ed walks in and she thinks, something looks lied. So she sees her Gick Sandmother buying in lead and she says, oh, grandmother, what ig buys you have? Big Wad Wolf said, oh, the editor to be you with, my dear. Then she said, oh, grandmother, what ig beers you have?
Beers?
Beers?
Oh, beers. Like,
yeah. And the big wad wolf said, oh, the editor to beer you with, Dimir.
Dumb ear.
Dimir. Not dumb ear. Dimir.
Okay, all right.
You got it?
No.
No, I didn't figure it. Then Riddle Ed says, oh, grandmother, what tig beef you have? And the big wad wolf said, oh.
To eat you with.
There you go. The editor to beat you with, Dimir.
Right.
Man. I'm so proud of you, Roy. Good gracious. 4 years and you're catching on, baby.
Right.
Well, the big wad wolf, he jumps up and he hobbles up Riddle Lead hole too.
Oh.
Yes, well, good thing, though. Huntsman comes along, because he had heard about the Gick Sandmother, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he comes and docks on the door, and again, Bo Naughty answers.
Bo Naughty.
So he opens up the door, and he looks in, and he sees that weaky old snuff. He was sitting there lacking his smips and rubbing his bat felly.
Oh.
And the huntsman knew exactly what happened. So he runs in, he takes out his narp shife and cuts open the bull's welly. Yes, sir, out jumps Riddle Ed and the Gick Sandmother. He daved to say. Well, everybody was so excited. So Riddle Ed's mother comes, and she decides she's going to make a feast to feed everybody. Oh, they were just excited. She brought some rot post with parrots and potatoes.
Wait a minute, say that again.
Rot post with parrots and potatoes. Had a little, you know, griskets and baby, too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. She brought a big old jug of teat sweet. Some fresh squeezed emmonlade.
Yeah?
Yeah. And your favorite, Dickin' and Chumplin's.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, boy.
I know what that is.
But yes, you know, sir. Roy, you know what that is?
Yeah.
So, all right. Well, you know, and every Maury has to have a storl.
Okay.
So the storl of this Maury is, if your mother is known for having the biggest, best bookies around, you better be... That's right. You better be careful when you get home. There's no telling what weaky old snuff might be buying in your lead when you get there, Roy.
It's time for another visit to the Cole Haynes of Cornfield County, television's beloved family of certified lewds. As we look in, we're discussing the current drought. We listen as Cousin Lulu says,
it's so dry here.
I was watching a revival of the love story, and I couldn't even work up a decent weep.
It's so dry, I spat into the wind this morning, and the wind said thank you.
It's drier than Milton Sewell's liquor cabinet.
I wish y'all would stop complaining. This is not half as bad as the drought of 1937. I mean, it didn't rain for 10 months. The lake dried up completely. Little ducklings couldn't learn how to swim or how to float. Man, it was terrible. And then finally it broke. I mean, it rained cats and dogs right off the bat. Great big old drop hit me on the head and knocked me slap out. They had to take a bucket of dust and pour over my face to wake me up.
Enough of this dry humor. What are we gonna do about this drought that's upon us?
Well, luckily, I happen to be a rainmaker. I'll mutter my magical incantation, and the heavens will open up. Make it rain across the nation. Give us some precipitation. Rain, rain, rah, rah, rah. Moisture, moisture, sis, boom, bah.
Tune in next time when we'll hear Cousin Grandpa observe.
Cousin Lulu, that was a thunder. Junior here has indigestion.
Charlie Farquharson here, your newsman in the KRON field. I'm stuck with it, and you're stuck with me, so let's stick it together. Phil Hickerson took his wife to the family doctor today, 'cause he don't like the look of her. Oh, heck, if he's gonna view her that way, why don't he just take her to the plastical surgeon? Well, this KORN reminder, daylight savings time ends tonight. The good news is, the clock you were too lazy to change back in the spring will finally be right again. Plus, you get that extra hour sleep. But the bad news, one more hour of election coverage. Well, there is less than a week before Election Day, and both Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump are telling voters that the other candidate would be a catastrophic choice for president. The good news is, both Trump and Hillary have both told the truth about something. Well, Hillary, she held a rally in Florida this week where she said if she's elected president, she'll protect America. Hopefully she does a better job protecting America than she did those emails. Senator Elizabeth Warren says, unlike Trump, Hillary Clinton doesn't get up at 3 a.m. to send mean tweets. Nope. She gets up at 3 a.m. to yell at Bill. That's about what time he's trying to sneak back in the house. Well, in some local headlines, Claudia Olliman is very excited about Thanksgiving coming up. As a matter of fact, she's already called the Butterball Turkey Line. The worker needed to know how thawed her turkey was, so asked, what state's it in? Claudia said, Tennessee. Well, now that the World Series is over and the Cubs are the champions, more attention's being placed on football. President Obama has picked the Super Bowl favorites. He says it'll be the Patriots beating the Seahawks. Well, if there's someone you can trust with predictions, it's a guy who said your Obamacare premium wouldn't go up. the U.S. Postal Service is warning people to get their online Christmas shopping done early, because the volume of packages they're delivering will be causing delays. In other words, business as usual down at the local post office. Santa's going over his list of what everyone wants for Christmas. He wants everyone to know one thing. He simply does not have the power to make Trump or Hillary disappear. And finally, Mayor Seaton and Miss Nona were taking a walk down Main Street. A pigeon flew over and just let one go. Hit Mayor Seaton right in the forehead. Miss Nona said, "I sure wish we had some toilet paper." Mayor Seaton said, "What the heck for? He's probably a half mile away by now."
Come on! Come on!
If any of you men out there got half a mind to get married, go ahead and do it. That's about all the mind I had when I'd done it.
My daddy is just tickled to death that you're a poet.
Oh, exquisite! Does he appreciate good poetry?
Well, no, but my last boyfriend that he tried to throw out was a wrestler.
Miss Ann?
Yeah?
Do you worry about what folks think about you?
Well, no, Lulu. I just let them worry about what I think about them. There just ain't no need in both of us worrying.
My wife sure ain't a very good driver. She only gets about 20 miles to the fender.
Junior went to a mind reader the other day. After only 5 minutes, she gave him his money back, with interest.
It takes two to make a marriage, a wife and her mother.
Utterly.
What?
You know that boy of mine, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
His head is just like a doorknob.
A doorknob? How so?
Well, any woman that walks by can turn it.
Buck, have you ever noticed how Minnie Pearl keeps her eyes closed when she's singing?
Yeah, she's a merciful soul. She can't stand to see us suffer.
Oh! Hay House Salutes Emble Community, population 1,244.
Salutes!
Hay House salutes the community of Sweet Lips, population 946.
Hall stage performing Blue Bayou, Dara Young.
I feel so bad, got a worried mind. I'm so lonesome all the time. Since I left my baby behind on Blue Bayou. Feel better again on Blue Bayou. time. Looking forward to happier times on Blue Bayou.
To help me quill. You know, I was thinking today, men folks, they so cantankerous.
Amen, sister.
Amen. My brother is so mad at me right now, he could spit. And all I done was back out of the driveway and hit his bicycle.
You did, Aunt Minnie?
I did.
Well, Aunt Minnie, was it your fault?
Lord, no, child. He ought not have parked it on the front porch.
That's right.
Oh, did I ever tell y'all about the first time I got kissed?
Oh, no.
Oh, girls, yeah. I felt like a tiger. I did.
You felt like a tiger.
Well, I did. Otherwise, he'd got away. Oh, I forgot to tell y'all. I had to call Miss Lizzie Tickham the other night in the middle of the night. Oh, wow. Yes, it was 9 to 8 o'clock. Yeah. That's late. Well, the reason I called is I saw a man prowling up around her house.
Oh, yes. My goodness, Minnie. Did you call the police?
Oh, Lord, no, child. I told her to send that man to my house. I keep my key under the African violet.
Them crazy scientists done fooled around with their experiments and done something that they shouldn't have.
You mean the big bomb?
Heck no, they discovered something besides corn liquor that'd cure a common cold.
Hey, Charlie. Wouldn't believe it. I had a lady come in here this morning and she kept her money right there in the top of her stocking.
Well, maybe she figured it'd draw more interest in there.
Come to think of it, the banks don't have branches like that.
Hey, Grandpa, what's for supper?
Well, let's see. Squirrel stew with crackers, hominy, and fried okra. Coconut cake and black coffee.
Yum, yum.
And now, here's Stan Krause performing the holiday favorite, Run, Run, Rudolph.
Oh, as Jerry Clower used to say, somebody told me before I come back out here, they said, Stan, you gonna get down? I said, yeah, I'm gonna get down. They said, well, Stan, you just ain't get down. I said, I'm gonna get down. When I'm finished, somebody had to come back and help me get back up. All right, so here we go. I'm ready, fellas. One, two, one, two, three. Run, run, Rudolph, reeling like a merry-go-round. So run! get to town.
I understand you don't like being seen out in public with me no more. Well, let me remind you of something, you old geezer.
Yeah? What's that?
I once was in the Miss America pageant, even if I didn't do too good.
Didn't do too good? You'd like to have lost your citizenship.
Well, let me remind you of something, you old goat. Remember when you were in the Mr. America pageant?
Well, I didn't get too many votes. I remember that.
Too many votes? You got 19 get well cards.
Am I really the only man that you've ever kissed?
Well, of course, Gordy. Boy, do I ever get tired of telling all these men the same old thing.
I remember when Halloween was still the scariest night of the year. But now, it's election night. Please welcome to the stage Ben Clayton performing Little Liza Jane. Thank you.
think it's fair to let your poor old wife do all of that housework while you just lay around all day and do nothing?
Yeah. Well, it ain't really all that bad. I got it all set up where she can work in shifts.
In shifts?
Yeah. When she gets tired of doing the plowing, she can shift over and do the housework. Oh.
Welcome to Grandpa and Minnie's Kitchen. What you got going today, Grandpa?
Minnie, I want you to try. I want you to try this new blend of coffee I came up with.
I'll sure do it. Grandpa, it's awful. It's awful. I believe it'd give up. A garbage can ulcers.
Is it that bad?
Well, it tastes like mud.
Well, it ought to. It was ground this morning.
Hey, Grandma got run over by a reindeer. Walking home from our house Christmas Eve. You can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe she'd been slugging too much eggnog, and we begged her not to go, but she forgot her medication, watching you, and trampled out the door into the snow. When we found her Christmas morning, at the scene of the attack, she had the prints on her forehead and incriminating claws marks on her back. Grandma got run over by a reindeer, walking home from our house Christmas Eve. There you go, come on. You can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. Now we're all so proud of Grandma, and Grandpa's taking it so well. See him sitting there eating a pimento cheese sandwich, drinking beer and playing cards with Cousin Mel. It's not Christmas without Grandma. All the family's dressed in black. I don't want to see that. Should we open up the present? Oh, or whatever we're going to do, should we open up her gifts or send them back? Hey, Grandma got run over by a reindeer, walking home from our house Christmas Eve. Now you can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. Now the goose is on the table, and the pudding made of fig. Oh. And the blue and silver candles that would just have matched the hair in Grandma's wig. I've warned all my friends and neighbors. Y'all listen up. You better watch out for yourself. I'm telling you right now, they should never give a license to a man who drives a sleigh and plays with elves. Come on, Grandma got run over by a reindeer. There you go, walking home from our house Christmas Eve. Now you can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. Sing it, Grandpa.
Grandma got run over by a reindeer, walking home from our house Christmas Eve. You can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and Grandpa, we believe. But as for me and Grandpa, we believe.
Merry Christmas.
The Hee Haw stage, Cousin Minnie Pearl.
Howdy!
Howdy!
I'm to be here. I'm so proud you're here, too. Especially you good-looking fellers. You know I'm always hunting a feller, and I spy one every now and then. I tell you, the other day, I seen this feller, and I was kindly looking at him. And I looked off, and I looked back, and he's still looking at me. So I kind of sidled up to him. I said, feller, was you kind of giving me a funny look? He said, lady, you got a funny look, but I didn't give it to you. Well, I'm going to tell you something happened to me here tonight. Scared me to death. I'm telling you, scared me to death. I was coming in here, and it's dark out there. Well, I was just walking, coming on in, and there was this perfectly strange feller. And he looked at me. He retched out, and he got a hold of me, kind of had me in the clinch position. And he said, I'm going to give you four guesses to name my name, or I'm fixing to kiss you. Well, you know me, I was thinking real hard on that. I said, Santa Claus. No, not Santa Claus. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. No, not Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Frosty Snowman. No, not Frosty. I got it. Red Butler. Guess what? He weren't none of them. So he kissed me. Sure enough, right square on the mouth, too. That's a real kiss. Well, then he kind of sauntered along with me till we got to the steps where there's a porch light. Oh, I was a-looking up in his face, and he was a-looking down in my face. And I said, feller, what made you kiss me like that? He said, I don't know, lady. I must have lost my dang mind. Well, I tell you, ain't none of us as young as we used to be. You know, this getting older just ain't for sissies. It's tough. You got to be brave. Why, you know, let's face it. I ain't got the figure I used to. I really don't. Now, don't try to say I do, because I don't. You know, I used to say my fortune was in my figure, but I reckon I must have had my assets invested in all the wrong places. You know, I still got an hourglass figure, but you know what? It's a later than you think. To tell you, I wish I could have brought my brother with me tonight. Oh, he's the sweetest old thing, I tell you. But he couldn't come with me. But I will tell you, he loves to ride the train. Now, I remember the first time, I'll never forget it. When me and him was going into town, he said, can I go with you and we gonna ride this train? I said, sure. So we went down to that depot and we got on this train and there we sat. Bigger than life and twice as natural. Just a sitting there and along comes this feller and he says, apples, oranges, and nanners. Well, brother ain't never ate no nanner, but he got him one. I tell you, he is just so careless with his money. He'll spend a nickel just like that, all at the same place. Don't think nothing of it. I'm gonna tell you, ain't no flies on brother, especially since we got that DDT. Well, we was sitting there, brother with his nanner, and didn't know how to eat the thing, but it just so happened that there was a feller right across the aisle, he had got him a nanner too. Well, so brother got them eyes trained right on him. That feller took his nanner pill and he peeled it down into his hands. So brother took his nanner and peeled the peeling down into his hands. Brother still a watching. That feller took a bite out of that nanner. So brother took a big bite out of his nanner. Well, about that time, we went through a dark tunnel. You couldn't see the hand in front of your face. I mean, it's dark. Well, we come out in just a minute, just short tunnel. I looked over at Brother. He's a sitting there looking something like it's right here. I said, Brother, ain't you gonna eat the rest of that nanner? He said, no, Minnie, I ain't eating more of that nanner. I took one bite of that nanner and went stone cold blind. Sure enough, but I tell you what, I've had me some fun on that train. I tell you, me and sister went into the town one day. We was buying some thread, bobbin, and, you know, notions. So here we are, we're on this train, and I knowed the tunnel was there, and sister knowed the tunnel was there. So we was on the train, and we going into town, and we start going through that dark tunnel. Well, this feller reached over and kissed me on the cheek right in the middle of that dark tunnel. Oh, Lord, when we come out, well, it's kind of embarrassing. I didn't know what to say. He didn't know what to say. Here it was, broad daylight, and we had done been kissing. He's a perfect stranger, too. Well, in a minute, I guess he finally got up the gumption to say something. And he said, I hear tell that train tunnel back there cost $1 million. I told him, I think it's worth every penny of it. Oh, yeah, that was the same day that me and sister, we was just nearly into town. We was just nearly fixing to stop at that depot. And the train kind of slowed down. And then it sped back up a little bit. Well, before you know it, there was this feller. He had jumped on this train. Now, he had a handkerchief. Y'all seen him? All around the bottom of his face there. Just a handkerchief. And he had two guns, one in each hand. And he said, I'm fixing to rob all the men and kiss all the women. Of course, sister, she jumped up and said, oh, no, you can't do that. I said, sit down, sister. Who's a robbing this train? Well, thank y'all for playing along. God bless you.
Well, the heavens have opened and torrential rains have been falling on Cornfield County for over a week now. And as we look in on the Cole Haynes, we find them protecting themselves against the elements. We listen, as Cousin Clem says,
I think we ought to get the roof fixed.
Either that or start wearing our rubber underwear.
What do you want me to do? Go up on the roof during this rainstorm and get soaking wet?
Why don't you fix the roof when it stops raining?
Cousin Lulu, you know that it doesn't leak when it ain't raining.
Tune in next time, and we'll hear Cousin Lulu say,
I'm lonely. I think I'll just dye my hair orange and red and have a Dalmatian set on my head.
Now to perform another country Christmas classic, Amber Guthrie and Mike McCutcheon performing I'll Be Home with Bells On.
Made lots of friends and memories, brought joy to others' lives.
It's Christmas time again, another year has come and gone.
I'll be home with
roses on the meadow and the sleigh bells jingle bright. And the kids are singing jingle bells around the Christmas light.
As Daddy stokes the fire and Mama puts the turkey on, ain't nothing gonna slow me down. This Christmas I'll be home.
Welcome to Old Honest as the Day is Long Junior's Car Lot. Come on down today, buy a car from me this weekend, and I'll give you absolutely free of charge 1 million S&H green stamps.
That's it, Junior. That's false advertising. When I get done writing all these tickets, they're gonna be yours.
Thank you. Are they for the Tennessee Titans or for the Big Orange?
You are such a big dummy. These here are citations. When was the last time you were cited?
Last night, my wife cited me when we was leaving the Elks Lodge.
Have you ever been up before Judge McKenzie?
I don't know. What time does he get up?
When I get through with you, Mr. Big Overhaul Bob Hope, the judge is going to slap a $5,000 suit on you.
Police brutality.
He's going to slap it.
For a price like that, I ought to get 2 pair of pants.
You're turning this into a dad-blame-living circus. I got to get work done.
You know, I was in one of them tents one time. They wouldn't even sell me a snow cone.
Oh, mercy. Junior. That's it. Do you have proof of ownership? Show me your pink slip.
I ain't wearing one. But if I was, I wouldn't show it to you.
Tell you what, I give up. I'm done. I'm going to go down to Freed Hardeman College and get somebody to arrest you. Bye.
Bye. Good to see you. Remember, friends, the number to call, BR-549-10-4 and out.
Now here's Sarah McBride performing Lesson in Leaving.
Somebody's gonna give you a lesson in leaving. Somebody's gonna give you back what you've been giving. And I hope that I'm around to watch them knock you down. It's like you love them and leave them, just like you love me and left me. It's like you didn't do that sort of thing over and over again. You're a foolhardy man. talking about me and some of my friends. Well, you better believe I'm not going through that again. You're the kind of man a woman thinks she can change, but the only thing changing is my way of thinking, thinking that maybe someday somebody's gonna give you a lesson and lose, and somebody's gonna do to you what you've been doing, and I hope that I'm around to watch them knock you down. Somebody's gonna give you a lesson and hurt, and somebody's gonna leave you with your fire burning, no way to put it out. Somebody's gonna give you back what you've been giving, and I hope that I'm around to watch them knock you down. It's like you love him and leave him, it's like you love me and left me, it's like you didn't do that sort of thing over and over again. You're a foolhardy man. Somebody's gonna give you a lesson and leave, and somebody's gonna give you back what you've been giving, and I that I'm around to watch them knock you down. It's like you to love them and leave them, just like you to love me and lift me, it's like you to do that sort of thing.
You're a hard woman to figure out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but it don't hurt to do some research.
Pioli, este niñito se la pasa diciendo tantas cosas todo el día. Grosero. Vas a ver cuando hable con tu madre. Majadero. Vas a ver, vamos a hablar muy pronto, muy pronto, muy pronto.
Nurse Goodbody. Did you know that Miss Linda Price was recently named the world's greatest housekeeper?
Oh, wow.
Yeah. She's been divorced 24 times and she got to keep the house every time.
Hey, Roy.
Yeah.
Needs to be Goober. You know, I love my woman so much.
You do?
Yeah, I do. I climb a mountain for her. I can't look at you. I climb a mountain for her. I wade a river for her. And there's one more thing I do, but I can't remember it. Walk through fire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You going to see her tonight?
Well, if it don't rain.
Remember now, if you walk under a ladder and a black cat falls on you, you're going to have 7 mirrors of bad luck.
Oh. Hey, Roy?
Yeah?
If you can see anything, do you ever see me on TV?
Oh, no.
Well, how do you like me?
Oh.
Salutes Marshallville Community, population 1,500.
Salute!
He also salutes Marshallville Community, population 612.
Salute!
Hall, welcome as we welcome back to the stage performing Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, Flee Temptation.
Wait. We're forgetting something.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, that's it. All right, hold on 1 second.
No. Hold this.
Now that's a selfie. All right. Everybody say hee-haw. Hee-haw! All right, thanks.
Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, calm and easy. I got a home on the other side.
Well, Ezekiel went down through the middle of the field. Saw an angel working on a chariot wheel. Wasn't so particular about that chariot wheel. He just wanna see how the chariot feels. Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, calm and easy. I got a home on the other side.
Swing,
Ezekiel went down and he got on board. Chariots went a bumping on down the road. Wasn't so particular about that bumping on the road. He just wanna lay down his heavy load.
Why don't you swing?
Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, calm and easy. I got a home on the other side. Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, calm and easy. I got a home on the other side. Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Swing down, chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, calm and easy. I got a home on the other side. On the other
the way I like to kiss you.
Oh, really? Well, maybe you'll improve with some practice.
Woo-wee! Practice is about to commence.
To dress up and make yourself pretty with lipstick and perfume and lace underwear. Now you sit around in your curlers and moo-moo. You need a weed whacker to cut your leg hair. Well, where are you tonight? Why did you leave me here all alone? I searched the world over and thought I'd love. You met another and he was gone. When I was a young un, my sweet mama
told me to find me a feller with money and class. You could be a rich man if someone would pay you for drinking and cussing and scratching your
woman.
Where, oh, where are you tonight? Why did you leave me here all alone? I searched the world over and thought I'd found true love. You met another and you was gone.
Hey, Ben.
What?
Where do snowmen keep their money?
Well, I don't know. Where?
In a snowbank.
Hey, Paul. What are you getting your little brother for Christmas this year?
I haven't decided yet.
What'd you get for him last year?
The measles.
Hey, Addison.
What?
When is it a good time for Santa to come down the chimney?
I don't know. When?
Anytime.
You know, kissing is just a way of getting two people so close together that they can't see anything wrong with the other one. Now please welcome to the stage Chester County's very own Mr. Jimmy Melton.
Thank you.
Excellent, excellent, excellent. Hang on to that until I get back.
Never had anybody do that before. It's pretty cool. I'm usually having to lay one down and pick up the other one. I don't play this a whole lot anymore, but anybody that grew up around me knew that I played one a lot as a youngster. So it wouldn't be a hee-haw show without a banjo. And a hee-haw is actually the reason I guess that I started playing a banjo. I watched it a lot when I was a kid. So y'all be sure and monitor what your children watch on television. This could happen to them. But we're gonna see how fast we can play this. It might be too fast for me. All right, we're key of G, y'all. Unless I change my mind. Listen to you.
Called, and her husband's been getting very angry when they sit down to have a conversation. She wants to know what she can do.
Nurse Goodbody, tell her to get a big glass of water and take a big sip of it. Swish it around in her mouth as long as she can. That'll do it.
Well, okay. How does swishing the water around in her mouth help her husband?
Well, you see, the water doesn't really do anything. But by swishing it around in her mouth, she keeps her mouth shut.
Doctor, did I tell you that Grandpa Jones called?
Nurse Goodbody, did you tell Grandpa Jones that I said a man his age, if he don't stop running around with that 21-year-old gal, it could be fatal?
Well, Doctor, I sure did. And he said, well, if she dies, she dies.
Okay, children, let's start class, boys. Wake up. Go to bed at night. Quit watching them cubs whoop up on them Indians. Wake up, wake up. Okay, you know, we have been studying all about the universe and the stars. Let's see. Luke Moody, wake up, son. Can you tell me what is a light year?
Teacher, a light year is a year without much homework.
Go back to sleep, son. Let's see. How about you, Precious? Can you tell me, little Sadie?
What are the dates of Antony and Cleopatra?
Sure, teacher. His date was her, and her date was him.
Yeah, teacher.
Yes, you're exactly right. Hudson, you are such a sweet boy and such a good student. Surely I can get a straight answer out of you. Say if I have 6 apples in this hand and 7 oranges in this hand, what have I got?
Well, I don't know. Big hands?
Now, Sunshine, just because I've kissed on you a few times, whoever told you you could just walk around here and neglect your duties?
My lawyer.
Elvis has entered the building. Performing Blue Christmas, please welcome Bill Maness.
I want to thank you tonight for being here. I count it a great honor just to get to perform tonight for you guys. So I'm gonna try to sing this song if I can remember all of my words.
I'm a half of a blue Christmas without you.
Richard has just been named Man of the Year.
Well, that is the kind of year we've been a-having.
from home lately?
Well, yeah, I got a letter from home just today. Got it here right next to my heart.
Heart.
Y'all know my folks, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
We had a good time up there, didn't we?
Oh, yeah.
Let's see what it says. It says, Dear String Bean. Well, that's me.
That's you.
Your brother Bob caught himself a wildcat Monday evening. But we wasn't able to catch Bob till Tuesday morning.
Oh.
Here it says, Your pa has got him a new breed of chicken. Says it has four legs.
Four legs.
So everybody can have a drumstick. But we don't know how they taste just yet, cause they ain't nobody been able to catch one of them yet. Oh. And it says here that a feller from a city-fied newspaper come up and over the hills and hollers to interview your pappy. He asked your pappy if he found it difficult to get the necessities of life way back up here in the middle of nowhere. Pappy told him, well, yeah, and half of it ain't fit to drink.
Well, Slee Hee-Haw salutes Mifflin. They have 872 folks living there. Salute.
Hee-Haw saluda a la ciudad de Henderson, población 6,488. Saluda.
Hello, sweetie.
Yes, Grandpa.
That sounded very professional, but I didn't understand a word you said.
Oh, Grandpa.
Would you please translate that into English?
Yeah, Grandpa, yeah. Hee-Haw salute, City of Henderson, population 6,488.
Salute.
And now performing the Ray Stevens classic, Mississippi Squirrel Revival, Zach Young.
Bought me a squirrel. I have no idea if it's even alive or not. Y'all mind taking a little trip for a revival on a Saturday evening? A couple of them, all right. Hear a little bit of organ going on. Oh yeah. I gotta follow Elvis, Jimmy Melton, and Flea Temptation. So if y'all are hoping for a good show, you might as well get up and go now. Let's tell a little true story about a squirrel down in Mississippi. Well, when I was a kid, I'd take a trip every summer down to Mississippi and visit my granny and her antebellum world. Come on, y'all. I'd run barefooted all day long, climbing trees, freeze a song. One day I happened to catch myself a squirrel. Well, I stuffed him down in an old shoebox and punched a couple of holes in the top. When Sunday came, I snuck him into church. Ha! I was sitting way back in the very last pew, showing him to my good buddy Hugh. When that squirrel got loose, it went totally berserk. But what happened next is hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell. But the fact that something was among us was plain to see. As choir sang, I surrender all, that squirrel run up, Harv Newman's cover hall. His heart leaped to his feet and said, something's got a hold on me. Yeah! The day the squirrel went berserk in the first self-righteous church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting hallelujah. Dancing and screaming. Some thought he had religion, others thought he had a demon. Harv thought he had a weed eater loose in his Fruit of the Looms. He fell to his knees knees to plead and beg, and that squirrel run out of his britches leg, unobserved, to the other side of the room. It went all the way down to the Amen pew where sat Sister Bertha, the better than you, who'd been watching all the commotion with sadistic glee. Should have seen the look in her eyes when that squirrel jumped her garter and crossed her thighs. She leaped to her feet and said, "Lord, have mercy on me." As that squirrel made laps inside her dress, she began to cry, then to confess the sins that would make a sailor blush with shame. Well, she told the gossip and church dissension, but the thing that got the most attention was when she talked about her love life. Then she started naming names the day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Baptist Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting hallelujah. Well, seven deacons and the pastor got saved, and $25,000 was raised, and 50 volunteered for missions in the Congo on the spot. Even without an invitation, y'all, there were at least 500 rededications, and all of us got rebaptized, whether we needed it or not. Now, you've heard the Bible story, I guess, how he parted the waters for Moses to pass. Oh, the miracles God has wrought in this old world, amen. But the one I'll remember till my dying day is how he put that church back on the narrow way. The half-crazed Mississippi squirrel, the day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Baptist Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting hallelujah. The day the squirrel went berserk, come on, in the First Self-Baptist Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews shouting hallelujah. They were jumping pews and shouting hallelujah.
The following story was related by the late Red Skelton on his television program, January 14th, 1969. As he related the story of his teacher, who felt his students had come to think of the Pledge of Allegiance as something merely to recite in class every day. Now more than ever, listen to the meaning of these words. The words of his teacher, his wise old teacher, Mr. Lasswell. "I've been listening to you boys and girls recite the Pledge of Allegiance all semester long, and it seems to me it's become monotonous to you. So if I may I recite the Pledge of Allegiance and share with you the meaning of each word. I, me, an individual, a committee of one, pledge, dedicate all my worldly goods to give without self-pity. Allegiance, all my love and devotion to the flag, our standard, Old Glory, a symbol of freedom, that wherever she waves, there's respect, because your loyalty has given her a dignity that shouts, freedom is everybody's job. United, that means we've all come together. States, individual communities that have united into 48 great states. 48 individual communities with imaginary boundaries, but united for one common purpose, and that's love of country. Republic. Republic. A state in which sovereign power is invested into representatives chosen by the people. And government is the people. But it's from the people to the leaders, not the leaders to the people. For which it stands. one nation, so blessed by God, indivisible, incapable of being divided, with liberty, which is freedom, with the power to live without fear or threat of retaliation and justice, which means the principle of being treated fairly for all, for all. And that means, boys and girls, it's as much your country as it is mine. So if you will you join me as we share the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You see, since I was a little boy, two states have been added to our great nation, and two words have been added to our pledge: under God. Now, wouldn't it be a pity if someone said, that is a prayer, and eliminated it from our schools as well?
Mushrooms kind of like the same thing. You don't know if it's any good for you or not till it's too late.
Well, Nurse Goodbody, is it hot in here or is it just you?
My boss.
Oh my goodness, Nurse Goodbody, whatever for?
Well, I asked for an advance and he made one.
Around everywhere I went. Every time I looked up, there he was. You think he was drunk?
Why, Minnie, you just took the words right out of my mouth.
Atropa navariophoba is the dread fear of doctors in the cornfield.
Now that's a phenuncicating word.
What in the world is a phenuncicating word?
Well, a phenuncicating word is something or another that high school educated folks talk about. You know it's big, you just don't know what it is. That's what it is.
That's phenuncification.
No, but I'll go along. That's what it is.
One more joke like that, and I'm just going to let the birds get them.
We love this time we spend with you to share a song. May your pleasures be many, your troubles be few.
night.
See you next time on
Hee-Haw! Ladies and gentlemen, your 2016 Hee-Haw Hootenanny casting crew. Let's thank our crew, including our stagehands, Jeremy Oliver and Richard Walker. Our producer, Emily Johnson. House manager, Channing Carroll. Sound engineer, Dale King. Lighting engineer, Jennifer Bingham. Stage managers, Renee Phelps and Tiffany Jones. Our director, Mark Barber. Tonight's entertainers, Ben Clayton. Stan Krause, Flea Temptation, Amber Guthrie, Buell Manus, John McBride, Sarah McBride, Mike McCutcheon, Jimmy Melton, Dara Young, Zach Young. Hey, how about it for Tim Young and the Good Time Band? Our Hee-Haw Kids, Ben Clayton, Ella Evans, Amelia Guthrie, Sadie Horton, Paul Jones, Hudson Lewis, Luke Moody, Ava Grace Northall, Addison Stanley, the Gossip Girls, Ann Thorne, Beverly Morton, Amber Guthrie, and Teresa Walker, the Hee-Haw Honeys, Claudia Olliman, Sarah McBride, Kim Stidham, and Mindy Moore, Ida Lee, Barbie Pullman, Charlie Farquharson, Shane Connor, Lulu Roman, Tanya Clayton, Grandpa Jones, Bob Brown, Gordy Taff and Laverne, Blake Garner, Kathy Baker, Presley Connor, String Bean, Ted Seiler, Goober, Jared Clayton, Cousin Minnie Pearl, Donna Butler, Junior Samples, Ronald Johnson, Nurse Goodbody, Mindy Moore, Archie Campbell, Brian McCarver, and your hosts, Buck Owens and Roy Clark, Mike McCutcheon, and Jerry Lowe.